never talk about this on the air, but I always want to talk about our love of vinyl.
Yes.
You have a vinyl, you have a record player, you love playing records. I love playing records. What's your favorite type of record?
Although Questlove's collection puts everyone to shame, I think.
He has a building that's just, yeah. I mean, it's basically a Tower Records, his apartment. Yeah, it's a giant record shop. But what do you enjoy listening to the most?
And oh, my gosh, so much. I mean, it depends on the time in the evening.
Yes, I agree.
You know, generally it's jazz or classical earlier on.
I'm glad you said jazz because I got you.
Come on.
It's a Count Basie record, and it's so rad. And when you listen to it, you're going to freak out.
You are so great.
Oh, no, please. You're going to freak out. That's the one that's on Pablo Records. But it's a great one. And let me tell you something. Through your speakers, you're just going to love hearing it, and it'll be like you're in a jazz club. It's fun. Because I know we talked about that when you were here. You told me that you like to crank up music and open your doors.
Thank you. That is my favorite gift.
Oh. Well, I hope you love it. I hope you love it. I think you're going to love it.
Yeah.
Well, because we were talking last time, you said you crank your music, you open your windows, and you take your dog for a walk.
I do, yeah. No, I live in Greenwich Village, and we have these big windows that open out. It's an old building that was built in 1820-something. And there's a big wrought iron window box, so I can sit in the window and turn on the music. And I like to listen to my music at the, whatever type of music it is, I like to listen to it at the volume that it would be at if you're there, if it's live. So if it's a jazz combo in a small club, then it'll sound like that. If it's a classical, if it's a symphony, it'll be at that volume. If it's the Rolling Stones, then I listen to it at that volume, that of what it would be like if you were this far from the stage, you know.
Your neighbors must love you. Oh my gosh, really love you.
I have a little problem with one or two of the neighbors. One night I was up in my window, and it was fairly late. It was pretty late. But I've always looked at it like I live in Greenwich Village. If you can't play your music loud on a Saturday night or a Friday night in Greenwich Village, where on earth can you?
Thank you. Amen to that. So, I agree. Anyway. Absolutely. You should be able to.
Yeah.
So anyway,
twice I've had a problem with one of the neighbors. So one of them, I was sitting in the window and I'm just sort of, you know, and it's screaming music. And I'm sitting here listening to music like that. And all of a sudden I see the neighbor from across the street comes out in his bathrobe. And all he does is come out into the middle of the street and go.
That's so New York. He didn't have to say anything.
He didn't say anything. He was like. I immediately jumped out of the window and like turned the music down. So, but a part of the thing that, and then the cops are called another night. But part of the problem is,
what about the cops? The cops are that.
Well, okay. I was playing it quite loud that night. I had a beef because the night with the bathrobe, that was like 1 or 2 in the morning. But this night was like 11 or something, you know. But it was pretty loud. But anyway, by the time the cops showed up, the doorbell rang. I was in bed already, and the music had been off for a half hour. But the doorbell rang, and, you know, there's not a great response time if it's loud music with the police.
We have other things to do.
Anyway, but the doorbell rang, and they said it's the police. And there's that instinct right off the bat where I was like, okay, the last 2 weeks, what sort of infractions?
I think I'm okay, right? Yeah, I didn't do it. Officer, yeah, what is this concerning?
I dropped that joint before the guy. Okay. So anyway, I ring them in, as if I'm not going to, if I'd done something.
Yeah, exactly.
I'm not going to ring
them in. Jump out the window, scurry down the pole,
I ring them in, and I live up 3 flights, so I felt badly, you know, these guys are coming up, then there are 2 of them, and they're like, have to come up. So I go down, and I like, meet them halfway down. I said, I'm so sorry. And they said, you know, it's the music. And I said, no, I know, it's a problem. But anyway. And I said, but it's been off for a half hour. And frankly, you know, that seems pretty reasonable. And I'm sorry I had to come all the way up here, but they left. But part of the problem is I walk the dog, and I live near Washington Square Park, and I love. When I leave to walk the dog, I'll put on a song because I like when I leave to walk the dog, when I'm coming back towards the house, I like to sort of hear the familiar dulcet tones of my stereo. You know? You know what I mean? Like, you're like a block away or so, or two maybe. Yeah. And depending if it's a quiet evening, you know, maybe 2.5, 3 blocks. Also, depending whether it's the Rolling Stones or not, you know.
There you go. I love
that
song.
It's like, yeah, Midnight Rambler.
Oh, I love that song. Oh, I'm playing it, yeah. I got it.
I have this thing in my heart because it's my stereo, it's my music. I'm like, yeah, and I'm like, I'm coming. Don't worry.
I have to turn you on to something called an iPod. It's going to blow your mind. You're going to freak out.